What's up, guys? How's it going? Mike the Tech here, and in this video I'm going to show you how to install the brand new virtual display driver beta. It includes a ton of new features, including the ability to set your own GPU, how many screens you would like, and even use a custom EDID. Before we get started, I want to give a shout out to Geeks Outfit. Definitely check out their collection of t-shirts, sweatshirts, and accessories. I'll put a link to their site in the description below. So onto the video itself. This is the virtual display driver, obviously, but we're going to scroll down until we see download beta Windows Universal Driver. So let's go ahead and click on that. This came out October 27th of 2024 and includes a ton of new features added by Bud. Specifically Bud, he went in and added a ton of great stuff, including ARM64 support, so all your ARM64 devices will work. So if you're an ARM64 device, click that. Otherwise, most of us will be using the x64 driver for Windows 10 and 11. Let's go ahead and click on that to download. And we're going to open that up once it loads. And you'll see that we have a virtual display driver in a folder. Now, we don't want to run this here. We actually want to open up our C drive. So go to your file explorer, go to this PC, and go to C drive. And then we want to drag this folder into the C drive. So we'll just drag it right there and open it up. It's very important that it is in that folder. Once you've done that, we're going to right click on installcert.bat and run it as administrator. It's important that we run this as administrator. Will not assign to the appropriate trust. So let's go ahead and press any key to continue, and we're good to go. Now, we still need to install the driver itself. So what you're going to want to do is make any necessary changes in the XML file first. So let's right click and open that and see what it looks like. And you can open this in any text editor. You can literally use Notepad for this. But here we can set how many virtual displays we want. So we can type 1, 2, 3, or even 8 if we want. And then this is the friendly name of your GPU. So if you have an NVIDIA 4070 Ti or NVIDIA RTX 4070 Ti, you would copy the exact name of your GPU and place it there, and it will use that GPU instead of your integrated graphics. Or you could leave it at default to use the highest end GPU by default. If you want a custom screen resolution, for example, if you use a Steam Deck and want to use 1280 by 800, all you have to do is go in here and either change or add a new resolution. So 1280 by 800, and then choose what refresh rates you might want. So maybe I want refresh rate 40 for the Steam Deck, because sometimes I like playing at 40 frames per second. So let's go ahead and save this and close. And now we're ready to install the driver. Let's just right click on the start menu and go to Device Manager. We're going to click on Display Adapters. And once we choose Display Adapters, go to Action and Add Legacy Hardware. From here, you're going to click on Next and then choose Install Hardware that I manually select from a list. And we're going to choose Display Adapters. Then we'll click Next. We'll choose Have. And we're going to browse to our C drive, go into Virtual Display Driver, and choose mttvdd.env and hit Open. Now when we press OK, it'll say the driver has an authenticode signature, which is important. If that doesn't show, then you'll need to redo this install cert step and then hit Next. The screen will refresh and you'll have a new driver here called Virtual Display Driver. If we right click and go to Properties, you can see that is the MikeTheTech Virtual Display Driver with all the relevant information, including the driver date. And we can go ahead and close this now, right click and choose Display Settings, and you'll see we have a new display. If we scroll down, we'll also see that it has that 1280 by 800 resolution that we set, and we can set it to that as well. Now, how would you normally want this set up? When you're using Windows and everything else, just disconnect the display. I just hit disconnect and it's gone, and all of my displays work like they normally would and everything's fine. Now, when I want to stream with Sunshine or something like that, what I usually do is I extend desktop to this display, and then I make the display my main monitor, which ensures that ensures that the games that I open always open on that monitor. And that's really important to ensure, especially if you have other displays connected. Then, of course, in Sunshine, which is a different video completely, you would go into the virtual display sync and actually type in the display name that we just created or that you want to use for streaming. But yeah, as far as the virtual display driver, that's it for this one. If you want to disable it, you just make another display main, click on the display, click on the virtual display, I should say, and then choose disconnect. And then it's disconnected as if you never even had it installed. If you do want to install it, just right click on the start menu, head over to device manager, click on the display adapters, right click on virtual display driver, and uninstall or disable the device. So let's go ahead and we're back to our two normal displays. But yeah, that's it for this one. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section below. As always, peace. The dude with the short fuse for ignorant minds. You can learn a thing or two about a new device. Unboxing kudos, we rock that pseudo. Administrative elevator command. Build it up or break it down in that virtual lab. From conversations to games to interviews with a broader view. He keeps it fresh, always brings something new. It's Mike the Tech, huh? MikeTheTech, the architect, huh? MikeTheTech, yeah. MikeTheTech, the architect, huh?